Welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. This week we have a singles match in the big clash between Matt Riley for 10 Pin City and Christian Purdue for Interbowl. Now we cross to our commentators.
Thank you, Simon, and welcome to all viewers to this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We're covering the New South Wales State League big clash, coming to you from 10 Pin City in New South Wales. We join the action at the top of the eighth frame, where Matt Riley takes a 13-pin lead. Christian Purdue steps up for Interbowl. Welcome, Brent Davey.
Thank you, Michael. We've got two very experienced players here. Great shot there by Christian, and needed it, being 13 behind. Matt Riley now for 10 Pin City. 18 perfect games through quite a distinguished career, with national and international titles. Throws it a bit differently to Christian. Standing way left.
He's done that well. Not quite the way left to way right shot that I'd envisioned, but he's kept that one well within the oil and gets the mix.
Well, as we've seen in previous weeks, a few shots missed outside of the target have tended to stay there, so looks like you've got to keep a bit of speed and a bit of tightness in your shot. Christian Purdue now.
Wow.
Two very solid shots, and that has reduced Matt Riley's lead to three.
Yeah, great shot there. He's way inside playing all the oil, getting next to no movement, which is an interesting observation, but it's done the job. Smash the seven out.
Carry doesn't come necessarily from hook, but definitely from Riley. He had the good roll on the back end.
Matt Riley at the top of the 10th.
Oh!
Almost getting the carry on the 10 pin there. Have a look at this, folks. 6 pin just sliding out in front of it.
Can be a bit of a byproduct of a deep inside line and a lot of ball speed. Solid spare though.
Oh wow. Bit of heat behind that ball.
Now this really tightens the match up. Top of the 10th frame, and it's a 3-pin match.
Very, very close here.
In fact, Christian Purdue can bag out and win. That's tight.
It's a circumstance of playing that tight a shot, you cannot miss. Inside just a fraction from his last shot and going through the beak, leaving 6-10. But what this means is that Christian Purdue cannot shut out Matt Riley. Matt will be bowling for the point.
That's correct. Christian's got the plastic ball out. He's standing left, going to shoot across lane.
Yeah, solid spare shooting. Takes out the hard case plastic and rolls it from the left to right. Comes off beautifully.
Maximum score for Christian now possible of 186. Probably an indication of just how tough these conditions are starting to get. This is the 10th game. The lanes not having been reconditioned, they're starting to play quite difficult.
If he does put a strike on the board here, it requires Matt Riley to at least mark. So it's important to get 10 here. And that's a great shot. He's wishing that one came on the first ball of the 10th. Wonderful delivery.
Matt Riley now needs to fill 16 pins. 8 spare 8 would be enough. Needs to fill 16. If he does not fill 16 pins, he cannot win the match.
Matt Riley been fairly accurate up to this point. See what he can do.
Oh, there it is.
Lovely. Got the point in the book. Well, just about. All he needs is a 6 count now.
Well, I reckon that time he's thrown that a little bit tighter and a little bit faster. You look at the angle of entry there. Definitely a shallower angle with more speed. And I think that extra speed might have been what created the messenger.
Oh, yes. You can hit that head pin as hard as you like. He's just made it skate around and pick it up on the bottom end. Matt Riley for a further 6. And it's enough. 9 count takes his score to 190. Just picks up the plastic. Hard and straight. And some action off the curtain there. Some heat on that one, but Matt Riley wins that game 191 to 186. Tenpin City take a 6-4 lead. Welcome back, viewers, to Tenpin Bowling Show's coverage of the New South Wales State League Big Clash. Coming to you from Tenpin City in New South Wales. We feature Christian Perdue once again from Interbowl with his 12 perfect 300 games.
And Christian finished that last match off quite well, so he may have figured a way in here. And that's a solid shot.
Great shot to open.
Christian is paired in this match with Dale Fitzgerald. And now for Tenpin City, Andrew Lloyd. And he'll be partnered by their lead-off bowler, Glenn Rowland.
Be interesting to see where these guys start placing the ball after watching the last match. Mind you, Andrew Lloyd is the only one on the left-hand side, so he doesn't have nearly half the problem.
And you would have to suggest that that would be an advantage.
He's playing further inside and playing more oil. And that's a lovely piece of carry. Great shot to start with.
Have a look at this one. Half pocket. Nicely played.
Generally works, doesn't it? Half pocket. It'll carry most. Dale Fitzgerald from Interbowl. Now to follow up after Christian Perdue's opening strike.
Being a Scotch doubles format, each player takes alternate shots. Dale now will be looking to build on the strike that Christian threw.
Gets a ball down nice and early. That's a great roll all the way. 60 feet to success.
It's a great shot in that the speed and the res match up really nicely on this shot. Picked the break point perfectly. 10 in the pit, that's about as nice as you can throw it.
And for Tenpin City, partnered with Andrew Lloyd, is Glenn Rowland. Has 7 perfect 300 games to his credit and a high series of 801. So he knows how to bowl.
He does. He's had a bit of trouble with his condition, although he's playing a bit straighter there. And that's probably the best shot Glenn's thrown in this tournament so far.
Well, when he hit the pocket here, he had such a good mix. The 5 pins slamming into the 7.
Gone with a bit more speed again, I think, that time, Glenn. And that was just a really good aggressive shot.
He'll take a truckload of confidence out of that one, no doubt. Both teams starting with a double. See who it is the first to blink. Christian Perdue stepping up in the third frame for Interbowl.
Ooh, a little bit high on that one. You get, again, it seems to be Christian's issue at the moment that when he misses inside. Like he just guides the ball just a hair. And on tight patterns like this, where you've got an out-of-bounds outside your target, then, you know, it's very easy to do.
Yeah, good point you make. It was identical shot to the shot he produced a little bit earlier in today's telecast, going through the beak. But Dale now left to clean up the crumbs. Gives the plastic ball a nice fist bump.
Looks like an oversized cue ball, that one. Imagine that one on your pool table.
You can put that one back in the rack. Andrew Lloyd now has the first ball assignment. He started with one. See if he can build on that on the left. Andrew does know how to throw the nut. He's thrown 21 perfect 300 games and has various national titles to his name. And that's exactly why, folks. Great shot production. Repetition going in here. Lovely hit.
That's the flush option, that one.
3-game series of 859, by the way, if you don't mind.
Yeah, you might suggest he was on his game that night.
I'd say so.
Christian Perdue now, having missed inside on his previous shot, needs to start striking because Interbowl have fallen behind in this match. That's a better shot.
Yes, great shot. Great positivity.
It's a good aggressive shot. Kept the ball speed up. accelerated through the target, and there's your result. As I said before, it's not necessarily hook that creates the pin action and the carry. It's about getting the correct roll through the back end of the lane. And that was perfect.
Glenn Rowland now stepping up into the fourth. Let's see if he can repeat the dose. Oh, wow.
Oh wow, there you go.
That is some incredible carry. Take a bow. That's not a trick shot you'll see too often.
Glenn, obviously, he's trying to keep the ball speed up. You can see he tried to throw the one really, really hard there, and as a result, he pulled the swing through a bit too hard, over-rotated too early, and suffice it to say, and you look on the replay here.
Oh, boy. That is one massive piece of luck.
Huge piece of luck.
Boy's having a joke about it in the background. Look, this puts some serious pressure on Dale Fitzgerald now. Oh, and what would you say? It's much better shot than...
A much better shot. That's really... That's kind of a psychological shirt front, that one. You've hit, you know, slightly high pocket, left a single pin, whereas your opponent's just thrown runaway Brooklyn and carried. Real psychological shirt front.
Yeah, sometimes that does happen in the world of 10-pin, but... Look, you just got to get on with the job, don't you? As Christian Perdue has done here. Hard case plastic ball, straight at the four. Exemplary.
It's the perfect spare. But Interbowl at the moment looking like they might just need 10-pin City to slow down a bit, because at the moment 10-pin City are looking very, very strong in this match.
Look, it's not like Interbowl have bowled badly at the moment. They've closed every frame, but what they haven't done is string strikes together.
There's only been one errant shot.
Oh, found some room out there.
Andrew Lloyd's just looking so solid, taking advantage of the fact that he's the only left-hander out there. He really looks to be freewheeling through the shot.
And you can just see by that picture there, folks, that the Interbowl team, their heads are down a bit. But 10-pin City, up out of their chairs, clapping on every shot.
The important thing there was Andrew Lloyd took full advantage of Glenn Rowland's piece of extremely good luck. See what Dale can do here.
Oh. Oh, there you go. It works both ways, see?
It does work both ways. The thing is now it's going to be up to Christian to throw a good shot and capitalise on that break the same way Andrew did after Glenn got his lucky break.
Look at that mob there, look a bit more happy now. Straight through the nose.
Now, a bright light, that'll lift your head very quickly. And Glenn's last shot was extremely errant, needs to throw a good one here. That's a bit inside as well.
He grabs at that ball very, very hard.
Big grab at the bottom of the swing there. Now, this for a right-hander is a very, very tough split. However, for the left-hander, coming at it from the left-hand side, this is a huge break. If Andrew Lloyd was right-handed leaving this, especially given the way the lanes are playing at the moment, this would be a super tough spare. It's not easy as is, but it's a huge advantage to have the left-hander shooting at this. So the breaks really are going.
That's a really good point you make. Have a look at how easy it makes it. Oh! You wouldn't tell. That is not the way you normally go about it. Takes the spare. We'll be right back. Welcome back, all viewers, to the 10-pin bowling show's continuing coverage of the New South Wales State League Big Clash. We're at Lidcombe for this tournament, and we're at the top of the seventh, where Christian Perdue has picked up his bowling ball, and I'll tell you what, that was a great shot.
It was, just looked like it just missed the roll on the back end. effectively at the moment. You know, 10 pin city are in the box seat. It's not a shutout yet. And effectively at the start of this frame, it was a 29 pin lead to 10 pin city, and they're leading the breaks 2-1.
Well, it's a continuing factor, isn't it? As Dale goes back and completes the frame. Good spare job. See Christian Pitti just showing a little bit of frustration. He knows he'd done everything right. It was a great first ball, but sometimes when the breaks just don't go your way, they don't go your way.
Yeah, it just looked to me as if the he just didn't quite get the roll on the back end on that particular. Glenn, the last couple of shots, he's really grabbed hard at the bottom of the swing. Needs to free will through the bottom, which I don't think was really his game.
I'll say not another break, surely. But he's got a bonus pin there, something flying out of the back, taking care of the six.
You have to say at the moment that Glenn's getting the breaks after the first frame, which he threw the ball really well. Good aggressive shot.
And Andrew being a left-hander, hooking that ball into the 10-pin. The 10-pin's probably not what Andrew would see a heck of a lot of, but have a look at that. They don't come much easier than that.
Yeah, just shot cross lane at it.
His last spare attempt, by the way, before the break. That was quite unusual.
Not quite the way you'd write it up in the book. Now, Christian Perdue.
He's got to find something. Oh!
And as a result of the ball just not quite getting the roll, the previous frame looked like he just backed off the speed a little bit.
But put the ball in a different spot.
And pays full penalty. Now, Dale needs to go for this. He has to shoot for the spare. Normally in a team situation, you would just go for the try and maximise the count. But given the state of this match, he must go for it.
Yeah, Tenpin City, you already have a humongous advantage. Got to go for the spare. Oh,
gave it a run, but not to be.
Taking the two. Not quite the angle required here. I would safely say that he gave that a go.
There's no doubt that he had to, really, to keep in a bowl in this match. Glenn Rowland now, been a bit fortuitous.
But Tenpin City have not opened a frame yet.
Ooh. That's a better shot.
Very good.
Notice there that time the follow-through just whizzed through nice and clean. Let's have a look.
Yeah. The ball left his hand nice and clean. Caught the fingers and the fingers only.
Yeah, definitely didn't grab it, that one. Much better shot.
Andrew Lloyd. That was probably a spare that he would see a little bit more of. The four pin. Notice he's taken out his hard case plastic. And relying on accuracy only. We'll have a look and see what he can do.
You're suggesting that a left-hander actually can rely on accuracy?
Oh, not at all. Not at all. Mind you, it does play a part. But, but when shooting on the left-hand side for a left-hander, you can't afford to hook it cross lane as he has the last couple of times. So,
just a little bit of a dig there.
Oh, of course.
Can't let a right-hander get away with too much. And now Christian Perdue back up again, and last couple of frames have been a bit of a struggle for Christian, one way and another, and he really needs to get out there and shoot a good shot here. Needs a good result.
That one not biting up as he would have expected. I thought the shot was good.
Again, he's fiddling around with his ball speed, trying to find the right combination of backhand reaction and length on the lane, and at the moment he's sort of going a bit
over and under.
Yeah, a bit over and under with his ball speed.
Yeah, placement was good though. Ball went right over the break point, or where I thought the break point was going to be, but angle didn't quite work. Dale going back now, and done that well.
The unfortunate thing about this match for Interbowl is though, I think Dale Fitzgerald has the better look. He hasn't had a chance to throw too many first balls. And that, I think, has probably been the main thing that's hurt Interbowl in this match so far. Really now, 10-pin City, a couple of marks, and that's all she wrote.
Yeah, that would be all she wrote.
Whoa.
Oh! Okay, two bonus pins there, but it's still a split nevertheless, and a small break going into bowl's way.
Very small break going their way, but I guess the reality is that that break's come too little too late.
Yeah, let's have a look at the scorecard here now. Inner bowl can go back and strike through for a game of 204.
And given the 10-pin City's 202 now, I think that between Glenn and Andrew, they can manage the three pins they need for the win.
No doubt.
And that's if Interball strikes out.
Well, look, what Christian needs to do right now is just throw a positive shot. He's got to find something to go on with, because this is not the last match of this State League Big Clash. He really needs to find something to encourage him in future matches.
And that's not it. That is not it.
Well, when you're down, aren't you? And when things aren't going your way, this kind of thing tends to happen. It was a little bit high in the pocket, but I'm not too sure that it deserved that.
The Interball guys now really need to get their heads together and just start to help each other line up. Because just at the moment, it doesn't look like there's a lot of chat between them all. They need to get their heads together.
See if they can nut out this show line. But the very next match on the calendar is a Baker match.
Exactly. So they all need to be able to get themselves lined up and shoot good shots. That's a 181 game for Interball. Not enough in this one. 10-pin City.
I'd say Dale Fitzgerald's got his spare game working. He won't have a problem there.
That's right. Now, Glenn's made a change of ball and line. So Glenn's obviously looking for something with the upcoming Baker match in next week's game.
Yeah, he made a ball change there, but he threw it about 15 balls inside where he wanted to.
He made a ball change, but I'm pretty certain he made a line change as well. It's pretty hard to make both changes at once.
Yeah.
Because he stood much further left on that shot.
But you'll take every piece of luck as it comes. He's had two Brooklyn hits and two strikes. So
Andrew Lloyd, on the other hand, he's lined up. He just wants to stay lined up. Big knee bend.
Oh, wow. That's fantastic.
And Andrew really is the big advantage for 10-pin City here, the fact that he is the only left-hander in either team.
Yes, his side of the lane is going to hold up, I'd say nine times more than the rest of the field.
You would think so. Now, last shot of the match. Glenn Rowland now. See if he can find the pocket.
Get something going for you,
mate. That's a better shot.
Great shot to finish. Glenn Rowland, take a bow. 232, 10-pin City. It's very impressive. Versus Interball's 181. It's another point goes to 10-pin City. They now take a 7-4 lead.
Thanks for your company today, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Good luck in bowling.